They are some of the biggest names in country music.
He better not mess up my song or whatever he's doing.
Someone else calling you, baby.
And I'm dying for people to hear it, hear all the songs.
Put you out of work at 2:45.
On what is known as country music industry's favorite night.
I mean, even as I look around this room, there's so many people here that I know are doing the work to make country music a more equitable place.
Living legends paying tribute to one another.
You can ask me 50 years from now, and I think I will probably say that's the biggest moment of my career.
Plus, the unsung heroes behind the music.
I love seeing people that are not always in the limelight come up and receive their awards.
Let's roll out the carpet for the Academy of Country Music Honors.
Nashville, Tennessee, that's it, right behind us, the country music capital of the world and home of the Academy of Country Music Honors, which you can watch exclusively on Merritt Street and Merritt Plus.
Of course, what's an award show without a red carpet? And that's why our Merritt Street studios have gone country.
That's right. In case you didn't recognize us in our Nashville finest, I'm Dominique Soxa.
And I'm Joe Gumm from Morning on Merritt. Fanchon would be here, but she's on the road getting her fill of country music on the PBR tour.
But before we check out the red carpet, let's get you up to speed on the Academy of Country Music Honors. There are two parts of the evening. First, the ACM Special Awards, presented to some of this year's remarkable honorees who've made significant contributions to country music. Second, ACM Industry and Studio Recording Awards. Those are given to musicians that you wouldn't recognize on the street. We're talking about the band members, to the producers, to the audio engineers.
The 17th annual ACM Honors is taking place at the historic Ryman Auditorium in Nashville, and this year will be hosted by Carly Pearce and Jordan Davis.
Now, back in May, Jordan Davis won the ACM Song of the Year award for his hit, Next Thing You Know. Now, even though he's no stranger to the ACM Honors, this is his first time hosting. Here's Jordan Davis on the red carpet.
I'm extremely honored that the ACMs allowed me to do this. I'm very happy that I've got Carly there to lean on. But man, this is truly one of my favorite nights of music, getting to honor some amazing icons tonight, Alan Jackson being one of them, getting to perform with Carly.
Don't rock the jukebox, I wanna hear some joy.
Getting to see Vince Gill sing is always amazing.
Oh, your love has ended, but mine still remains.
It's going to be a special night.
Well, obviously, he's taking it all in, right? His first time hosting.
Yeah, host nerves, man.
Total host nerves.
We'll get through it.
We've had those before, yeah. Hey, for Carly Pearce, in the meantime, this is her fourth time hosting the ACM Honors.
Mm-hmm. It's just tired of keeping me out of my head.
Here's why she keeps coming back.
We get to honor not only the artists that have made the impacts of the year, but we get to honor the people behind the scenes, because it really does take a village to make all of our dreams happen every single day, and they deserve to be honored in a big way.
Hey, Joe, and speaking of taking a village, what's going to be really cool here is that Jordan and Carly are going to be performing a tribute to Alan Jackson, who's being honored this year with one of ACM's Poet Awards.
My heart ain't ready for a rolling stone.
Alan Jackson was such a staple of my childhood, listening in the car. He was the soundtrack to so many of our lives that I feel like now we're trying to take pieces of what he created and bring them to light now. I feel like he's as relevant as ever. But he's just the pioneer of songwriting. He had such a simple way of depicting the common man. And I think he's just one of the most brilliant songwriters and artists ever in country music.
I mean, Alan Jackson is country music. I mean, it is just an absolute icon. You know, his songwriting and ability to trap you in. I mean, I can tell you exactly where I was at, you know, when you hear songs like Remember When, or when you hear songs like Chattahoochee. And not a lot of artists have that ability. And I'm very honored to be a part of a night that we get to celebrate him because he is. He's a true legend.
Way down yonder on the
Chattahoochee.
There you go. Hey, Jackson is one of the select honorees this year, and he's in great company. The Academy of Country Music will also be honoring these much-deserved individuals, such as Lainey Wilson, Luke Bryan, Walt Aldridge, Trisha Yearwood, and many more.
Now let's talk about Lainey Wilson, who's going to be receiving not one, but two major awards, the ACM Triple Crown Award and the Milestone Award.
The Triple Crown Award is given to artists who have won the ACM New Female Artist of the Year, the ACM Female Artist of the Year, and the ACM Entertainer of the Year.
Lainey Wilson earned her place in this elite group after taking home the ACM's Entertainer of the Year award this past May.
I just feel so honored, and also just to be like recognized by the people that you look up to and your peers, people who have influenced you, inspired you, and now I get to call these people and get advice, and it feels nice to be a part of the movement of what's happening right now. I've had a lot of pivotal moments in the past year, but the one that takes the cake is becoming a member of the Grand Ole Opry. I was 9 years old when I went to the Opry for the first time, and I remember thinking, I'm going to be a part of their family. They don't know it just yet, but I'm going to be. And I'm glad they finally realized that I was part of the family. So that right there is, you can ask me 50 years from now, and I think I will probably say that's the biggest moment of my career.
Wow, 9 years old, she already knew the dream.
Isn't that something? Yeah. That seed was planted early.
And what a great example to others. Lainey will be honored by Terry Clark, who will take the stage to perform Lainey's hit song, Hang Tight, Honey, from her latest album, Whirlwind.
Happy to be honoring Lainey tonight. She has just pole vaulted over everything in music, and she's winning all the awards. She's winning a Triple Crown tonight and a Milestone Award in a very short time, and I think that it's a testament to her work ethic, her talent, her showmanship. She's got it all. You know, I've had the pleasure of being on stage with her a lot this year, watching her entire show, and She's there's no slowing her down. She's just going to keep going. She's a steam engine that's going to keep going.
All right, Lainey Wilson,
yes,
the triple threat.
Good job.
So Shoot. Impressive.
50 years, she said. She'll be doing this another 50 years.
As well she should. With yep. a voice like that, mm-mm.
No doubt.
Well, we can't wait to see what the rest of the night holds.
Stay tuned. There's more to come. In fact, we'll be talking to Luke Bryan, Jason Aldean, Trisha Yearwood, and many more.
Plus, our own Fanchon Stinger takes us from the red carpet to the PBR.
We do a really good job in country music of getting together to celebrate one another, but this is one of the nights where we get to spend, like honoring Tony Brown tonight, we get to spend a whole night focusing on the people that love him most, the producing that has caused so many of us to pursue the music industry. I think tonight is one of those nights where we really get to focus in and celebrate.
I guess something must have happened, and we must have said goodbye. My heart must have been broken, though I can't recall just why.
And welcome back to the ACM Honors Red Carpet on Merritt Street. Are you ready to meet some more stars on the red carpet?
Yes.
Well, the Academy of Country Music is going to hand out two icon awards, one of them to legendary record producer Tony Brown, and the other one to country music powerhouse Trisha Yearwood.
Now, Tony Brown has been a cornerstone in the history of country music, from playing piano with Elvis to infusing his mark with the likes of some of these people you may have heard of: Vince Gill, Winona Judd, Reba McEntire, George Strait, among many others.
Yeah, I've heard of them. And of course, who doesn't love Trisha Yearwood? Her career defined by groundbreaking achievements, including being the first female country artist to sell over 2 million copies of a debut album and topping the charts with her unforgettable hit, She's in Love with the Boy.
Yeah, she's done pretty well, right? She's
I'd say.
Trisha's compelling storytelling and powerful voice has inspired countless artists and captivated fans for the last three decades. Here she is on the red carpet talking about this prestigious award.
It's strange, you know? I mean, I never thought this far ahead. I really just wanted to be a singer. And when you look at the names on this list, Amy Lou Harris and Dolly Parton, Merle Haggard, Garth Brooks, you know, I haven't really let it settle. I'm just trying to smile and enjoy myself, but it's very surreal right now.
Well, as they say, the cream always rises to the top, and there she is.
And very humble.
And very much so. Isn't that beautiful?
Yep.
Okay, so here's the million-dollar question for you. Trisha is a singer, songwriter. She's a best-selling author. She's an Emmy winner, entrepreneur, and more. So are you wondering, how on earth does she do it all?
I say yes to the things I think I'll enjoy, and I'm at a point in my life where that's easier to do, to just say, hey, I think I'll really enjoy doing this. Because if you love it, it never feels like a job, and you put your heart and soul in it. And then, you know, when one thing, if I'm making new music, then I'm not writing a cookbook. And so you just sort of, it balances out, because one thing takes precedent and the other thing is on the back burner, and then you switch them up. So I love being, I'm busier than I've ever been in my life, and I wouldn't have thought that, but it's great.
Mm.
That is a full plate.
She is so busy.
I would cut it off there, but I've got a feeling she's going to add more.
Oh, my goodness. And she's married to a guy who you know, he's pretty good at what he does. Yeah. Hey, let's get to one of my favorite all-time male artists. Luke Bryan is about to receive the ACM Lifting Lives Award for his remarkable farm tour.
This is so cool. You see, Luke's farm tour raises money for American farmers and rural communities. And the concerts aren't in big arenas. Oh, no, no. They take place on farms.
Farm tour started with humble beginnings. And we just wanted to have a party in a field. And as it grew year in and year out, and as my career grew, we were able to partner up with great corporations with a lot of power to feed a lot of families, and giving scholarships to kids while we're out on the farm tour has been amazing. So it's just, it felt like the right thing to do since day one. And we've just always had a great time with trying to give back as much as we can.
Obviously, that's a huge deal for Luke, but the farmers. Mm-hmm.
Well, I love how intimate it is. It's bringing the concert home and for a good cause.
They appreciate it. A lot of big farms out there that need help. Well, honoring Luke will be one of his great friends, Jason Aldean.
I saw Aldean, and he better not mess up my song.
Someone else calling you, baby.
You can expect for me to just try not to mess it up. I think Luke and I kind of came up in this business together, and we've kind of been there for each other when some of the biggest moments of our career, and just kind of struck up a friendship almost 20 years ago that, you know, is still going strong.
Man, I wish they really showed that they loved each other.
I know, right? If only they knew each other better.
If only we had a show to highlight them and their friendship. Obviously, they're buddies, and what a great honor. Hey, we're going to get back to Nashville in just a bit, but right now, let's catch up with Franch and Stinger on the PBR tour, where bull riding goes hand in hand with great music.
I guess you can call this kind of the PBR red carpet. When it comes to music, the PBR has every single genre covered, especially country music. Over the years, as part of the PBR family, we have welcomed in so many amazing country music artists. One in particular, Jenna Paulette, a lot of you know her. She actually sings the national anthem for many PBRs. And one thing I've talked to Jenna about is her reverence for the national anthem and for this country. She said that her grandfather and her father taught her that when she sings the national anthem, she is actually paying reverence to the song. She says, it's not about me, it's about our country. And you can see that in how she sings that song.
Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Another young lady who has graced the PBR stage is also Charlie Reynolds. She has sung the national anthem at many of the PBR events and even the world finals. And there is so much history when it comes to the relationship between PBR and country music. In fact, my friend Matt West has some information on a PBR coach who also made a special appearance at the Grand Ole Opry.
Thanks, Fanch, and I'm joined by my friend Kate Harrison, and our friend Justin McBride, who just happens to be the head coach of the Nashville Stampede, has actually worked with some great songwriters out of Nashville, like Gwen Varble, Bryce Long, and has taken his talents to the stage of the Grand Ole Opry.
And he'll be the first to tell you he has not performed there just once, but two times.
That's right. That's right. But that's not the only tie to country music that we have in the PBR. We've had so many stop by and grace us with their presence over the years.
Oh, and then a bull was named after Reba McEntire. Brantley Gilbert owns a bull that is on tour right now. And you just never know who's going to show up and either sing or just enjoy bull riding.
We had Tanya Tucker singing our national anthem this year. Keith Urban snuck in and was in attendance. Tim McGraw, Shania Twain, so many have stopped by. We even had Jelly Roll perform at Kid Rock's Rockin' Rodeo, just to name a few. So to me, sounds like country music and PBR kind of go hand in hand. And to be honest, we like it that way.
I know that when my family and I attended the PBR event in Duluth, Georgia, a couple of weeks ago. During the, I guess, intermission, we had a country music star right there in Georgia.
Right.
And he sang three or four songs. It was great. Everyone loved it.
Don't you love it? You know, and I feel like in Merritt Street here, we are Americana.
Yeah.
We are bringing it all home to you.
Yeah, the two certainly go hand in hand.
They do.
Hey, still to come, Keith Urban, Jesse, Joe Dillon, and more.
Chasing that neon rainbow. Yeah, living that honky-tonk dream. All I've ever wanted was to pick his guitar and sing.
Welcome back to ACM Honors on the Red Carpet, but here is a look at Broadway, downtown Nashville. You know what I love about that street? Not only do you hear music coming out of every place you go by, but it's like stacked.
Oh, everywhere.
Four layers high. It's everywhere.
And you're sitting there walking going, who is going to be the next great star?
I know.
They could be in these buildings right now, they performing could, and auditioning.
True. And each one of them thinking, I hope it's me.
Yeah, and then we're going to talk about them here in a couple of years. Among so many talented people right there in the country music industry, being honored tonight, we also honor Chris Stapleton with the Artist Songwriter of the Year Award.
His fellow artists say nobody deserves it more. We caught up with Jamie Johnson on the red carpet and asked if there was one Chris Stapleton song he wishes he had written.
There's just so many of them. He's one amazing writer. I'm so proud I've gotten to write a few songs with him. But just glad that I live in an era where we all get Chris Stapleton songs, you know?
One's the devil. One keeps driving me insane. At times I wonder if they ain't both the same.
Okay, so let's flip over now on the women's side. The one and only Jesse Joe Dillon will be honored as Songwriter of the Year.
I started crying immediately when Damon told me, and even today, it still feels so surreal, almost like I've sort of processed it, but not really. I'm just so thrilled and grateful.
I love it when the young artists are thrilled to be there, and you could see it in their demeanor.
Oh, she's just bubbling over.
She's totally bubbling.
Can you imagine years to come, how much more?
And get this, Jesse Joe Dillon is the daughter of country musician and songwriter Dean Dillon. Mm-hmm. She grew up surrounded by country icons. We ask her how she found her own voice and, of course, her own style.
It took time for sure. Just living, you know, and your own influences and then things that have happened to you. And then over time, you kind of just build your own little cave of yourself, I guess.
Okay, so clearly she's on a roll.
She is, yes. I think we all are. Well, we love him,
I think so too. Okay, so we were also able to catch up with Keith Urban on the red carpet, who has just released his latest album titled High.
Yeah, yes, it's 11 tracks. And I worked on another album, scrapped that, and ended up making this album. Yeah, and I'm dying for people to hear it, to hear all the songs.
I'm out tonight and I'm feeling like I should call you up, maybe take a shot, put you wide awake at 2:45. As messed up as me, all alone, and all your friends have all gone home.
Man, he is so busy. His album, of course, just dropped 2 days ago. But his wife as well, she is all about Hollywood. She's everywhere these
days. She's everywhere. Her latest Netflix show, The Perfect Couple.
Yep.
I'm binging that right now. So I just say between Keith and Nicole,
keep it coming.
Yes, we love it.
Yes.
Whatever they're doing, we love it. Keep it going. Hey, that's a wrap on the ACM Honors Red Carpet Show. Thank you so much for hanging out with us and tuning in here on Merritt Street.